Well, today I'm going to test or not test, just let you hear a little bit of the Jamo J203. And they are very nice looking speakers, my friends. But why I like this test special for me is it a test to test my Rode microphone for the first time. Rode NT4, just ordered it. And here's the box. I'm not sure. It is working because I see that I have a level meter for my microphone on this camera. I plugged it in the camera, and this is how the test will be today. But in the future, I will plug this microphone in a Zoom microphone. That one have a memory card, and that one can take 128 kb, 320 kb, everything you want, WAV, also high resolution audio quality. And that's why I prefer to work with that Zoom as recording device instead of this camera, because not sure, this is a test video, not sure in what quality this microphone will record when I do it directly in my camera. It's just a test, and I'm very happy with it. I paid only 175 including the shipping costs. The normal price of this microphone is 400 euro. The only thing what was strange is that when I place the battery inside, the battery is now inside, it is recording, but the red bulb only flicks up just for a moment, not even a second, when you place that battery inside. But while I'm recording now, that bulb is out, so not sure why that is. I have here a button, not sure what it is. Let me see what's happening when I touch this button. Well, nothing really happened. Anyway, I have to leave it like this. And today it is about these Jamo J203. Let me stand up in my hallway, because I have a buyer, my friends, and this buyer is coming to pick these speakers up in an hour. And I thought, why not make a video? Okay, as you can see, the woofers need new foam, they need new foam, but yeah, I can make a video anyway, why not? And and so these speakers are from 1981, and it is like everybody wants these speakers now. The value of these speakers, so without when the woofer rings are repaired, at the moment in the Netherlands is about 300, sometimes 350 euro. Yeah, it all depends on the state of this speaker, you know, and how mint these speakers are. Well, so they are from 1981, and this is not the biggest. If this one was the 253, I would never have sold the thing, because that is even a bigger monster. That's a bigger monster. So the one to keep, the one to hunt for, the 253, the G253. Remember that, my friends. And I already saw, for these speakers, I saw prices in Germany. They asked 800 euro for a pair. 800 euro. And 800 euro, no, 750 euro in Australia. So the disease also reached these speakers. But I can tell you that 800 euro, even if I cannot hear them, I heard them before years ago. It was in 1995, 1996, I heard them in Serbia, and one of those cafes had these speakers, and I thought they sounded dull. You know, so I experienced the speakers before, and I can tell you that 100% that even if these foam rings are repaired, the sound will be lousy. And so to ask 800 euro for a pair of these speakers, it's crazy. The only thing they have is the looks. They are beautiful speakers, my friends. Watch this. Beautiful speakers. Beauty, 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 beautiful. And so, but to ask 800 euro for lousy, because they sound lousy. If you have these speakers and you think that the sound is perfect, the sound is good, I can tell you, open your eyes, you know, probably your brains, because they are so beautiful, your brains are completely out of control. They think they sound nice, but these speakers do. I had the Jamo in 19, let me see, I was 22, 23, in 19, let me think, in 1994, no, it was before that time, 1994, I don't remember, I can't recall that, exactly that date, but I had the Yamo Push-Pull 2504, so 2504, Yamo Push-Pull, that one was monster. But yeah, in those times, you know, I went for the looks and thinking of me that I have to listen to those speakers again. Yamo was cheap. That was Yamo. At the moment, Yamo is owned by Fox International, the same company what owns, the same company what owns Canton, Magnat, and Clips. Yes, so Yamo is now in Fox, in the hands from Fox, but at that period, when I was young, I loved Yamo because they were cheap. They were cheap speakers, because you could pay. You could not afford Marantz speakers or Tannoy speakers in those times, my friends. So, when I was young, I loved Yamo. I loved Yamo because of the prices. And well, I can tell you that 100% sure people who are going to pay, I see prices 800. Well, in the Netherlands, people are not that crazy. I don't think nobody will pay 800 for these speakers. It's crazy. I bought these speakers because I thought I paid cheap for these speakers, very cheap. And I thought, you know what, I'm going to refoam them. But in the end, I am too afraid to spoil these speakers. I don't have zero experience in refoaming speakers. So I leave that to a guy who knows what he do, and you know, because if you do it wrong, if you do the reforming wrong, you can throw away the speaker, and they don't deserve that. They are beautiful speakers. I can understand why people buy these speakers, because they are just beautiful. 25 kilo, you know. Watch these speakers, my friends. Beautiful, beautiful Yamo YG203. And this is how they sound over my new microphone. Yeah, yeah, yeah. And this is how they sound. I placed the bass completely back. Well, let me push some bass. Thank you. this is... I'm crazy. To let you hear this. Speaker, the left speaker is sounding much better. This one. Don't take this test serious, but I have to say I'm a little bit surprised. Only, and this speaker is broken, and even now it sounds nice. Don't take it serious, this test, because, I mean, but yeah, I want to hear them anyway, so I have to connect them anyway for the buyer who's coming just in an hour, and I think, okay, why not hook the Accuphase on it to see how it sounds, and, you know, if you're going to buy speakers and you cannot test them, you're not sure if the, let me put out the amplifier first. And you're not sure if the woofers are still good, you do like this. Oops, this one is out. This speaker is out. This one is. Let me test it out. Well, I'm not sure, but it looks as if they are out. And So there are more problems as only the woofer rings. Well, the guy is coming. If you buy them like this, I'm happy. I'm rid of them because they are too big. I have now some more space in my stereo. All this stuff I have to sell, my friend, because I needed the space. And well, thanks for watching this video. Put your thumbs up, and I'm so curious how it sounds over my new microphone, the Rode microphone. Probably my voice is now weaker than normal, because this microphone is really, you know, it is only going that way. I can spin now my music much louder, because this microphone have a SPL from 143. And not sure if you are familiar with those things as SPL, but I can record it. I can with this mic. You can stand in front of a band, first row, so with the loudest music, and you can record without distortion. This good is this microphone, and in stereo, so you don't have many of. Well, I think this is the best stereo mic you can have, can buy, and I will later when I'm going to edit. That's what I'm going to do now. I'm curious how the sound of my recordings improved. And because, my friends, because I make money with YouTube, but you know, I want to grow, and to grow I need to make investments. That's why I bought this thing. I also bought a Zoom microphone, because what I think now, I think that my camera only record in 182 or 128 kb, and when I connected to that the microphone to that a Zoom microphone, I can record in a much higher quality. So I know that YouTube is compressing sound, but then I will upload in 320 kb instead of 128 kb, and that's a big difference. I'm not sure how much YouTube compress sound, but yeah, we will see that. Anyway, this was the Yamo G203, and I think what I just heard, you know, they are not bad sounding, not at all, because that one, the left one, sounded pretty nice, you know, even with that, you know. In fact, if a woofer is in a state like this, it should sound very bad, you understand? But I'm surprised that even in this state, it can produce this sound pressure, this bass. So I think I will hunt for those 253, G253. And whenever I score a set from those, it doesn't matter if the woofer rings are rotten, I will refund them, or not myself, but I will pay a guy to do it for me, because those ones are monsters. These are monsters, but the G253, those ones are the real monsters. Those ones, if you have those ones, it would be stupid to let them go, you know. But yeah, I have to make some room to sell other speakers in my stereo room, so in the future I have more room for, well, speakers like these, you understand. Okay, thanks for watching. Put those thumbs up. And for now I say ciao, ciao.